Okay, we have our hot box and our test fixture ready to go. Now I could say we have three hot boxes, but actually it's just two hot boxes, and you might want to call this a cold box. There's no glazing on it, so without sunlight, the temperature that the probe will record will actually be less than the ambient temperature due to the evaporation. Anyway, these are the three temperature readings that we're going to take with our test fixture. Now all I have to do is add a little water. I'm going to add some water to the, we'll call this the cold box. Okay, that's the polyester felt. And we'll also add a little water to our hot box. So let that soak in a little bit. Okay, so all we have to do now is add a little, an inner film for our polyester felt hot box. Now that's to prevent the evaporation of water and also the condensation of the water on the glazing surface. And we also have our aluminum absorber. Like, we don't need an inner film on that because there's not going to be any water flowing on here. So we just put this on, and there we go. We're all ready. Our test fixture is ready to go. We're going to just take this and screw it into a tree and take some temperature readings around 3 or 4 o'clock. That is, as soon as we get a little sun around here.
Well, we don't have quite as much sunlight as we might like to have for this experiment. In other words, we're not getting the peak amount of energy today. As a matter of fact, it's probably much less than I would really like. Right now it's about 100 BTUs per square foot. That's just a rough estimate. I don't have a pyranometer today. All my data loggers are used to gather temperature information. It's not too cold today. It's about 40 degrees or so, and we have a temperature probe on the north side of the tree. It's almost like there's almost the same amount of light on the north side of the tree as the south side, so I don't expect there to be that much light energy to raise the temperature in our test hot boxes. Now you can see there's three boxes. There's actually two hot boxes. They're the one on the top. The one on the top is the it has a felt absorber that's saturated with water. Number two, it has an aluminum absorber plate painted black. And number three is just a polyester felt. It's been saturated with water, and then there's a temperature probe in back of it. Now I would expect this to be rather cold. It might even be below the ambient temperature. That's what I'm guessing, because when the water evaporates, it has a cooling effect. Of course, there's some light that's hitting it, so that's going to raise the temperature a little. I don't know. Well, it's hard to tell just by looking at it to estimate what these temperatures will be. So let's take a look at the graph.
I neglected to activate the ambient temperature probe, so there are only three temperature plots to worry about: the covered felt plot, the uncovered felt plot, and the aluminum absorber plate plot. The ambient temperature during the day was about 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and I believe the solar flux intensity hovered between 100 and 200 BTUs per square foot. The only thing that kept the wet exposed felt above 60 degrees is the sun. Without sunlight, I would expect the exposed wet felt temperature to drop below 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Notice the piece of aluminum painted black reached 106 degrees after 6 minutes. The enclosed polyester felt reached 125 degrees after 6 minutes. Does this mean the polyester felt makes a better absorber material than aluminum? I don't know. I think it depends a lot on how it's used. Please continue with the hotbox experiments and let us know what you discover in the comments section below.
A wee mower, 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 a wee mower,